look like how I look on here, Instagram. Let's not do the catfish thing. But I do look crazy sometimes, you know. Everybody got their days. So anyway, I retweeted, because you gotta give credit where it's due, because people like to say this, they own something they don't. I'm very shady. Anyway, keep it private so you know it's permanent. I'm big on that. Like, I'm so big on that because I feel like people don't wish you well all the time. So I feel like you keep it private, especially if it means a lot to you. Like when I started my YouTube, I didn't tell a lot of people I was gonna start YouTube. So I didn't want people to wish bad on it. And like when I have like things coming up, I don't tell people because I do not want people to be like, oh, I'm gonna duplicate the same thing, or I'm gonna pray on her downfall. Like things like that, I'm really like into keeping your business private, especially things that's really, you know, that means a lot to you. So I retweeted that. I put, whoever is gonna be my partner needs to be positive so we can balance each other out. So I'm very picky. A lot of things usually annoy me. I'm a perfectionist, drive myself insane, and I need somebody positive that's gonna like be like, babe, babe, I'm not an actress, so don't come for me, y'all. Babe, like, it's all right. Like, it's gonna happen when, you know, like something positive, like, you know, like, cause I'm be like, oh my gosh, my weave, I ain't find my weave. I can't find my other earring. Like, I'll be all in shambles. I need somebody to be like, babe, you look good without earrings. You know, like, it's fine. Go to work. I'm gonna get you a new pair. I'll meet you when you go home. You know, like, come on. So, it's just an example. I need somebody to balance my crazy. But it's just a little crazy like me, so. I put, you got the swag, so see dripping swag. Ooh, I like that song. I was listening to it and I just tweeted it on Twitter. I put, I be going off on Twitter. Y'all gotta follow me on Twitter, I swear I have to. So I put, nothing more whack than a deadbeat parent. And yeah, mothers can be deadbeats as well, not only men. Don't be sexist, ignorant, or fooled. So people, when they refer to like deadbeats, they always think that it's the father. When mothers can be deadbeats as well. So you have to be open-minded. Some mothers don't want to be parents as well. They pack up and leave just like fathers do. So don't think out the box. I don't like when people feel like, oh, men only do something. Like people like, oh, only men cheat. Women cheat too. I know women that cheat. And I've witnessed it. It's not only in movies, but not only men cheat, not only men leave their child. So I don't like people that don't have an open mind. Like, I'm still growing too with certain things, but I try not to be ignorant, you know? So I don't want y'all to be ignorant either. So yeah, I have put that. Because a lot of people don't have their moms. A lot of people don't have their dads. So it's not only dads are deadbeats. Deadbeat definition don't have a man next to it. So just think outside the box. I don't want anybody to feel like it's only men. I cracked myself up. So I put, I'm so tired of seeing them floral Gucci slides. I'm tired. That's what the boys say. Tired. Sorry for those that listen to my headphones. I'm so tired of seeing them Gucci slides with the floral print and the tigers. And then they have another one floral print. It's like pink and green and I don't like it. I don't want to see it. Let it go. Your aunt have them. Your sister have them. Your mom has them. I don't know if they were on sale. I don't like them. Be original. Please leave that. And when was it? 2017, 18? I don't know. I don't want to see it next summer. Please. I don't. They are everywhere. Like, come on. It's just too much. It's too much. I'm sorry. I don't like them. I don't own a... I own a pair of Gucci slides, but not floral. You could barely tell they're Gucci slippers, mines. And they're actually really uncomfortable, so I probably won't be wearing them again. They're black, the jelly, they're like jelly material, and it says Gucci, but the words are in black and the slipper is black, so you can't barely tell that it says Gucci. I like things like that, because I don't like flashy stuff. I don't like people looking at me like, oh, she got money. No, I don't like stuff like that, so, yeah. Oh, I put, who's hacking Beyonce's phone, because... how are all of these pictures out and she didn't post them? I'm so puzzled. Have you ever seen all the pictures of Beyonce and the twins and all that? Like, that's what I was referring to. Somebody hacked this phone, but I'm not mad. It's nothing like invading like privacy, personal things. So I like to see it because she haven't been posting since the concert thing, Jay-Z's concert thing. Oh, I put, the fact that I am more aggressive than guys, than some guys, is an issue for me. So I was walking with my friend, not my friend, my coworker. She's gonna be mad at me when she sees this. So I was walking with my coworker and people don't try to speak to me. So I don't know why people feel like I have all these people trying to talk to me. People do not try to talk to me. Some people say because maybe because I look mean, or maybe because I look like too well put together that they feel like maybe I wouldn't talk back to them, or whatever the case is. People have like different scenarios on why people don't talk to me. I don't care, because if you're shy or if I intimidate you, you're not for me. That's it. So I'm walking with my friend and a girl tried to talk to me, and I'm like, wow, a girl tried to talk to me, and guys never try to talk to me. She's very bold. Of course I kept walking because I don't like catcalling. Like, you're not, nobody's gonna pick me up in the street. I don't know where I would meet somebody because I don't go out. Yeah. So anyway, yeah. So I was like, no. Oh, and have you ever heard somebody ever say, are you from the K? I'm from Brooklyn, but there's a lot of alphabets missing if he's talking, trying to say K still for Brooklyn, because I never heard that. But I know Brooklyn is the county of kings, so maybe he was referring to that. I'm not sure, but I'm from Brooklyn. I'm proud. Brooklyn all day. I say it in a lot of my videos. I'm so proud of being from Brooklyn. Everywhere I go, I'm like, I'm from Brooklyn. I don't even say I'm from New York. I say I'm from Brooklyn. So proud. So, yeah, if you haven't heard of somebody saying the K and that being equivalent to being from Brooklyn, let me know what that stands for. But from right now, I think it's for kings, maybe. Okay, so I'm gonna let this be the last topic because I don't want this video to be too long. So I put, the convo I had with my coworkers, laughing my ass off, such an interesting topic. So my coworkers and myself, we were talking, and I think it was all ladies. I think one guy was in there. And we were in the office, and they were saying that their guy can't love pictures. You know how on Facebook you go thumbs it up, love it, laugh, be shocked, something like, it's different reactions. Or on Instagram, you like, when you double tap, you loving the picture. So one of my coworkers were like, my man can't like love nobody's picture. He could barely like anybody's picture, but he could scroll. I'm like, well, dang, like, why does he have social media? Like, like, I never think too deep into those things. Like, social media is to like things. If I had a man and he liking things on Instagram, like things on Instagram, that's what Instagram is for. I've never thought too deep into things like that. Like, cause I'm gonna be liking pictures too. I'm not gonna be going looks with, see what you like. I don't care that deep into anything. Like, I feel like that's too much. And I want to know what y'all thought about that. So comment below. If you got a man, can he heart things, or he can only thumbs up, or he can't like anything at all? Me, I don't care. Like, I really don't care. Like, it's just certain things that don't bother me. Like, I feel like that's you putting too much energy into things. If my man can't like anything, he shouldn't have social media, because that's what social media is for. To like it, to comment, to network, to find people that you lost, you know? So it's like, I'm not thinking that much into anything. I don't know, like, I'm laid back. A lot of people feel like I don't care, because I'm so like, whatever, like, I'll be chilling, like, I don't care. And I'll say thank you to Zoe for this shirt. It's Beyonce's homecoming shirt, and she got different expressions. Woo! That was cool how I did all that. And I want to say thanks for all my birthday wishes, all my birthday gifts. And September, you've been so good to me. God, you've been so good to me. My friends, my family has been so good to me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thanks for all my subscribers, all my Instagram friends, all my social media friends. Thanks for all the love. Thanks for all the birthday wishes. Thanks for all the prayers for those who believe. And thanks for all the good energy for those who don't believe. Everybody's welcome to this channel. I just want to say I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And thanks for the love. Like, I can't believe I'm still on YouTube. And I know one person asked me why I started YouTube. I spoke about that in my videos before, but I'll say it again. I started YouTube so I could connect with people that I can't physically touch, because I know it's people out there that agree and might think like me a little bit. Everybody's unique in their own way, but I know there's somebody out there that might relate on something with me that I can't relate with my sister or my friend. So I want somebody to sit and watch this and be like, dang, like, she's mad, she's my homegirl through a screen, you know, like, oh, I needed to hear that, or I need that advice or things like that. Like, I want to be a big sister or something like that to somebody. I'm really into, like, empowering people, and that's why I have a YouTube channel. And I want to see, I want to have this documentation for maybe even me to look back on and be like, dang, I needed to hear that again, because maybe I'm not in that space right now. Or like how you go back to a photo album and be like, oh, that's where I was at that time. Okay, I need to get back to there. Or I'm glad I grew away from that because I was a little immature there, or I didn't think too much out the box. So it's like, you know, it's for different reasons why I made a YouTube channel. But it makes me happy. I've always wanted to make a YouTube channel, and I hope that answered your question. Thanks for all the questions that y'all had for me. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Thanks for kicking it with Ivy one more time. Love you guys. Besos.